There's a big political element to the poetry, which is very strongly evoked even in these three pieces that we were able to perform in a larger group. And in the first bit, Sarah was talking a little bit earlier about these found sounds from Gaza and bombs falling, and that's illuminating an aria in which he's singing about how, you know, land redistribution at the end of the Roman Republic and the beginning of the Empire, where they would, you know, could just brutally come in and take land away from people.
You cover the poor man's bones with no. Lucky me, radiant night, and you couch made fertile by my pleasure.
There's quite a split between sex and love, and in this there isn't. There's not a split.
Yes, that's absolutely
spot on. That's what I found very attractive about the piece, very enticing about the words.
While the fates permit us, let us set our eyes on sex.
Love is so fragile and rare in anybody's life, and we should take advantage of it. But yet, woven into that is this idea. I mean, he's in the aria that we heard, a long night is coming for us, daylight never to return. I mean, these images, I feel, as one grows older, start to have more, they evoke more in us. And then just completely enhanced to another level by Sarah's said, I mean, it's more than a setting, it's kind of like a whole embodiment of the poetry.
sound in there.
Well, yeah, I was going to say you're so inventive and so creative, because very often music that's computer generated can be a kind of loss as against an orchestra, that there's something missing of that.
For my money, what you have not to do is try to sound like anything other than what you're doing. You really, really have to go into the sound and really manipulate that sound and not think, I need it to sound like a this or I need it to sound like a that, because then it's just hopeless. You may as well just get the real thing, and if you can't afford it, you may as well just play a recorder. That's how I sort of feel about it.
Yeah, I mean, you're so right. That is really good advice, Sarah, for any composer embarking on this kind of stuff, I think. There's no sense of loss with this music. It's all a sense of gain. It's really interesting hearing how successful it is. I've been involved in so many new operas now, literally hundreds, and many times over seen somebody going, oh, where do I get a librettist? I know, I'll ask a poet. And it's usually really unsuccessful. I think the reason being that the job of a poet as against, say, a dramatist is very similar to the job of a composer. But there's something really pleasing and magical about what's happened here, because it just worked.